I started to hunt when I was a sophomore in high school in 1959. Shot my first deer in Lafayette County.
First buck, I was 13 years old. And it was a spike buck during a snowstorm. I got lucky.
This larger doe came out and I lined up on her and made a clean shot. She went down right there in her tracks and everyone was pretty happy and excited.
Land, soil, forest, and water, plants, and animals. To a landowner, these are more than words. These are the essential components of managing a property for the wildlife we all enjoy. To a hunter, it's even more.
Today we're holding a deer management assistance program workshop where landowners can come to the workshop and learn about habitat management programs and land management techniques that they can hold on their property, and then also tour a property.
A landowner can improve their habitat by looking at what they have to start with in the first place. It's important to landowners of Wisconsin. Deer are high level of interest for hunters and provide a lot of recreational value and economic support to the state.
We now own 325 contiguous acres, which gives us enough property to be able to experiment with some of the recommendations that foresters have made to us to ensure the long-term health of the land.
So by managing actively for deer, you're also benefiting habitat for a lot of other species such as turkeys or ruffed grouse or woodcock, but also for non-game species such as golden-winged warblers or other songbirds or small mammals. It's basically going to bring your forest alive.
Across Wisconsin, landowners are joining the Deer Management Assistance Program, or DMAP, with increasing regularity and, not surprisingly, for a variety of different reasons.
I own about 270 acres, some ag land, mostly forest land, recreational.
Bob's been an extremely active landowner, spent a lot of time out on the property, not afraid to invest in the land in different practices.
I have two sons and I have two daughters. We're constantly trying new things, different things, and I'm open to it.
He obviously enjoys spending his time outdoors and trying to improve his land, not only for himself, but you know, mainly for his family and the future generation that will have his land someday.
I'm looking to do something to enhance the current value that I have for future generations. And I want to leave a legacy with the property that we own that, in generations to come, it's better than what it is today.
Of course, the kind of changes that last generations don't happen overnight. With the help of DMAP and the expert advice of DNR wildlife biologists and foresters, property owners create long-term land management plans that outline the goals and objectives that are unique to each parcel of land, however small, or in some cases, quite large.
We're managing about 900 acres we actively manage here. We kind of favor planting the oaks for mass for turkeys and deer. They seem to have the most value for wildlife.
My dad and I, we've gone through actually some classes together. We've done timber stand improvement together, planted food plots, a lot of tree planting, spent countless days and hours here with him. It's been a really great experience.
Well, I think I'm fortunate to have a son-in-law who appreciates hunting and who appreciates that land. We own some land together and appreciates the land and puts a lot of time and effort into hunting and the land.
Being able to do it with a wonderful group of people. I don't think they, you know, the people here really realize how wonderful it is and how fortunate they are. It is pretty special.
Being out at the ranch here is, it's great to be able to experience it, deer camp every year with my dad and my grandpa, and look forward to it in years to come.
Managing a property for wildlife involves applying proven habitat management techniques and collecting important data to monitor progress towards property goals. Collecting biological data from the harvested deer provides insight into the results that active habitat management has on the deer herd.
We've been collecting hunter data since 1994. It started with hours hunted, deer sighted, and deer killed. It's expanded to taking of measurements of the deer, photos, also where the deer are harvested. Aging we do through the jaw. So we have a chart that we use to compare ages.
So the type of people that are enrolling in DMAP are those that are just interested in doing good things for their property, not only to benefit deer, but other wildlife as well. And so a great definition of these people are stewards of the land, and they really take a lot of pride in what they're doing.
So whether you're just starting on your first move to the country, an experienced hunter, or a seasoned landowner that cares about maintaining the beauty of the land for future generations, the Deer Management Assistance Program has the tools and the expert knowledge to help you shape your dreams and turn them into reality.
It's no single point of satisfaction. Rather, it's the collection of all those images and impressions that is the long-term satisfaction of being an engaged property owner.